بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه ملء السماوات وملء الأرض وملء ما بينهما وملء ما شاء ربنا من شيء بعد وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أجمعين أما بعد حمد أن ثناء شكرا توفيق أردوت أو الرب كريم أرحم الراحمين صلاة أن سلام أبن أور إمام أور سيد أور حبيب محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله again and again that we are here connecting our hearts, our souls in the footsteps of the beloved. Of course, all of us should add the most beloved, or as we say it sometime in Qiraat and Quran, to do this number, to raise one's voice, to say Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, with this emphasis. So if I can say it in the English language, we say, in the footsteps of the beloved, اللهم صل عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم. To love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam is one of the greatest ni'mah, greatest favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To feel this inside your heart, that he is, اللهم صل عليه وآله وآله وصحبه وسلم, the dearest to you. Why? Because we all know, we believe it, he is Rasul Allah. These two kalimas here. He is the messenger of Allah. And any of us, when we have this, we just ask ourselves, somehow, the other side of this statement, in the footsteps of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the beloved, if we are not taking these footsteps of he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, of his, that he is our guide, our imam, our sayyid, who else? That's the question. Who else we are taking? Who else footsteps we take? What direction that will take us? He is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. If we love him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam truly, really from the depth of our heart and put him as he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was put by Allah jalla jalaluh to be dearer to us than our own selves, we recite in the Quran عليه وعلى آله الصلاة والسلام in regard to this, النبي أولى بالمؤمنين من أنفسهم وأزواجه أمهاتهم. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم is closer, is dearer to the مؤمنين than their own selves. أزواجه أمهات المؤمنين, his wife صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم, and may Allah be pleased with them رضي الله عنهم, أمهاتهم. Allah سبحانه وتعالى declared who are our mothers in faith and who is dearer to us, that we should work to get his blessed love صلى الله عليه وسلم in our heart, true محبة in our heart, than our muhabbat for ourselves. And we do this, when we work on this, we will gain many, many due to the time. We'll have these three ha, ha as we teach tajweed sometimes, middle of the throat, you have not the bottom of the throat, not ha, it's ha. And they try it, they try ha. Ha is hub, hub of who? Hubbullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will have the love of Allah. Allah Jalla Jalaluh will love you. Allah put you as you are beloved to Him Jalla Jalaluh. Second, halawa, halawat al-iman, sweetness of iman. And third, ha, hikmah, wisdom. With the first one we recite in the Quran, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم قل a command from رب العزة الله سبحانه وتعالى قل as we have قل هو الله أحد قل أعوذ رب الفلق قل أعوذ برب الناس قل say يا محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم قل إن كنتم تحبون الله say if you say you love Allah if you have this claim كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني follow me. Follow me. We're taking this statement in the footsteps of the beloved. Follow me. فاتبعوني يحببكم الله. There is no qira'ah. There is no style of recitation say يحببكم الله. It's يحببكم الله. تكثير الحروف لتكثير المعنى. يحببكم الله. Surely, definitely, guaranteed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves you. You become a friend of Allah. You become beloved by Allah, Jalla Jalaluh, Rabbul Alameen, the creator of the sun, the moon, the earth, the universe, the controller, the one under him is kun fayakun. You walk, you talk, you study, you start business, you get married, you are with your friends, you speaking from your phone, whatsoever you are, but you are a friend of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalal. يحببكم الله. And in the same verse, ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم, and forgive your sins. Promised by Allah. You follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. You have mahabbatullah, you have love of Allah. You have maghfirat of Allah. That's why some great imams, they said, guaranteed ittiba'u sunnah, sababul maghfirah. Following the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam is the main cause of forgiveness for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahu ghafurur rahim. First, mahabbatullah, hubbullah lak. The second, halawatul iman. How much I speak about myself is, and you feel this halawatul iman. There is something when you are alone, you're never alone. You're never alone. You're never alone. You always taking the advice of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said to his cousin Abdullah ibn Abbas, Ya ghulam inni u'allimuka kalimat. Oh young man, I'm teaching you few words. احفظ الله يحفظك احفظ الله تجده تجاهك احفظ الله. Protect the deen of Allah. Safeguard the deen of Allah. Save Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in all matters that you are. يحفظك. He will protect you. You're never alone. You're always with the rahmat of Allah. Who is? بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Who is Allah Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim? In the same page, Allah is reminding me and you with the surah that we all know. We don't need any tarjama, translation for the meanings of it, surah Al-Fatiha. In the same page, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, the first line, and then the ayah, number three, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, don't forget. Don't forget, you are in easy time, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim is there. Don't forget, difficult time, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. You have a challenge, is there Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim? you find yourself alone, you're never alone. It's there. Jalla Jalalullah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that the sweetness of Iman, you are protected. You are there. In the hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ثَلَاثٌ مَنْ كُنَّ فِيهِ. Three. If one to have them, وَجَدَ بِهِنَّ حَلَاوَةَ الْإِيمَانِ. Surely he will find the sweetness of Iman. We know when they say in Arabic, halawa, and Urdu, I hear it many times, halawa, sweetness, you will find it. Something nobody can speak about it. No language can express, no volume of books can be written about it. But there's something I and you, the people who believe in Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will find it. Halawa al iman. And the third, hikmah. Hikmah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you wisdom. Because He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us, وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ. These two. The more you follow the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the more you step out of your house, the more you step in to your house, the more you drive your car, the more you stand in the bus stop following the sunnah, the more you go to your college, your clinic, your shop. Before you do anything, you say, in this moment in time, here in Manchester, if Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam is here, what advice would give me? You're looking at the seerah, you're looking at the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. On the way to here, I prepared a gift for someone. Yeah, not to be surprised with big, but he left it, subhanahu wa ta'ala, Sheikh Yasir. And I was saying, I should have the best, as much as I can, of the carrier bag to give him. And what's ever possible to put in the carrier bag. Why? Then I mentioned Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told Umm al-Mu'minin Aisha radiallahu anha. And why Umm al-Mu'minin Aisha radiallahu anha used to put the itr and ask my daughter on the way to here in the car, do you know what is itr in English? I know, of course. She said, yeah, scent. This is sweet smell. It's nice. Why Aisha radiallahu anha used to put this sweet smell, this scent, nice, on her dirham, the piece, you know, this little change before give it to the poor person. She used to say, I learned, إِنَّا تَقَعْ فِي يَدِ اللَّهِ قَبْلَ أَن تَقَعْ فِي يَدِ الْفَقِيرِ. It is, goes to the hands of Allah before it reaches the hands of the poor person. That's the connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I was saying to them in the car, and my student is here, I was saying, this gift, you give it for Allah before you give it to your brother, that you welcome him as he's our guest in Manchester. This connection that we learned from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the sweetness of Iman, from the sweetness of Iman to the hikmah of action. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of us. If one is weak in following the footsteps of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, may not be a great sin. May not be even a sin at all. If one unintentionally to drink with his left hand, unintentionally to do this, unintentionally to leave out this, will we have any impact by not learning, not implementing, put it in practice? By not promoting the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the way of life for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, take another huruf al-halqiyya as well. I'm interested in huruf al-halq. Yes, take the kha. We will have these two: kha khasara and kha khatar. Khasara, loss. Innal insana lafi khusr. والعصر إن الإنسان في خسارة. What is خسارة? Loss. Let's to say, one is not concerned before going to sleep to follow any sunnah. It's tired, just drop your body whatsoever way you like. You're tired, just go to sleep. Any loss? There's no sin. Say Bismillah and sleep. What about just few minutes before going to sleep? You will sleep according to the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And if you sleep without the sunnah, what loss? You drink without it, knowing some of the sunnah. Some ask me, how many sunnah in drinking? I said, some ulama come with them 29 sunnahs of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. 29 actions you can learn. Just drinking. You know 2, 3, 5, 6? Say so you put them aside. And you drink. Is a loss? It's a loss. Why lost that few minutes? You lost them. Walking, talking, shaking hands, standing the way. You don't ask yourself how I should stand. The distance between you and a sister in the university or a sister in your clinic, the distance between you and a brother. How you stand in queue? When you're waiting for a train, for a bus to buy a ticket, is any sunnah to do this? Yes, must be sunnah. Must be sunnah. Encyclopedia of Religions, Encyclopedia of Britannica, they say Islam is a complete way of life. Sometime from time to time, they say, Ya Allah, please let me and many of my dear students and scholars to know it is a complete way of life. It is 24/7. You have no moment to lose, to miss out the word from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and becoming closer to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalalu. And gain in return, His love subhanahu wa ta'ala comes on you. Every moment, you are not loser. Second, khatar, danger. If the sunnah goes away and is not a sin, it will not take you out of forgetting about your fara'id. Is any danger? Is any trouble? If that space you live in your life will be filled with something else, with different custom, different culture, different role model, and as individual, you'll have your own lifestyle. It is 2019, isn't it? Am I right? 2019? Sometimes I say, remember, it's not only 2019, before that, it is 14, 42, 41, 45. Any mashallah, raise your hand, 40, 14, 41? Yes, because some of our young people, they don't know 14 what? I remember Lord Ramadan and Dhul Hijjah. And once upon a time, in the timetable of Salat, it was 1339. So ask after 5 years, it says here, Hijri, 1339 still. We are in 1441. You ask them, my dear brothers, my dear sister, and my dear young Ibni, and alhamdulillah, I have some of grandchildren in university. I'm old enough, alhamdulillah. I say to my young people, grandchildren and children, okay, this is empty now in your time. You have 24 hours. This is empty. We'll be filled with something. You don't have to go in details. That thingy, that's it, that thingy, ready to what? Will take you to what? Wasting your time? There's a very minimum wasting your time. You are not rewarded. And if not, step two, wasting your time to something. And that something, that thingy will take you to another thingy. And Shaytan, he does not have one step. The Quran and Allah warned us, وَلَا تَتَّبِعُ خُطُوَاتِ الشَّيْطَانِ خُطُوَاتِ الشَّيْطَانِ. Relate this to understand what does it mean in the footsteps of the beloved. So, if not on the footsteps of the beloved, we'll be on the footsteps of who? We have to ask ourselves as individuals, as family. My dear brother, Yasir Qadi, was talking about some misunderstanding, conflict, and it's getting even worse, astaghfirullah, in some areas, in some community, between husband and wife. If we take the sunnah out, and slowly, slowly, the life of sunnah is being taken out, what's going to happen? We haven't changed the curtains. The same stove I've been using for the last 5 years. The fridge, so look, there's something. The sunnah comes in our house, takes the dispute out. As community, Muslim community in Manchester, Muslim community in New York, Muslim community in Chicago, Muslim community in wherever. Slowly, slowly the sunnah goes from individuals, from families, what is left. What's left? The 5 times salat? Work it out 5 times salat? 10 minutes each will be 50 minutes, less than an hour. So my 24 hours will be less than 4%, around 4%, and 96% of my day will be elsewhere. So the danger is being filled with something. How dare I say to myself to leave the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the one who paid me favor no one else Allah created has done favor to me and to you. Is the one that he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left no moment, but he was concerned for me and you, and he called us, the Ummah, that's you and myself, and those who come until the last day, he called us Ahbabi, my beloved. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, wa ashwaqahu ila ahbabi. Oh, how much I miss my Ahbab. The Sahaba said, Ya Rasulullah, alasna Ahbabak? We are not your beloved. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained, those who will come after me, and they believe in me, and they haven't seen me. يَوَدُّ أَحَدُهُمْ لَوْ افْتَدَى أَنْ يَرَانِي بِأَهْلِهِ وَمَالِهِ. Some of them would be ready to sacrifice his family and his wealth to have a blessed look at me, at Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam so much, because he loved us so much, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All the anbiya alayhi salatu wa sallam, with no exception, it's been repeated over and over, inni akhafu alaykum, I fear for you, I am concerned for you, I am worried about you. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reached that, فَلَعَلَّكَ بَاخِعُ النَّفْسَكَ عَلَىٰ آثَارِهِمْ. بَاخِعُ النَّفْسَكَ. Go and read in Surah Al-Kahf and Surah Al-Shu'ara, what does it mean in English? بَاخِعُ النَّفْسَكَ. You perhaps will kill yourself. Why? Allah is addressing his Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam out of grief, out of sorrow. You're so worried about with them. You're so worried about with them. You're ready, ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to go after them. عَلَىٰ آثَارِهِمْ. You're following their footsteps. So they can come to you. They can believe in Allah. They can be successful in this dunya, in akhirah. They die with the full kalima, la ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. They have peace in this world here. And they have peace in their qubur. They can answer who is. مَا تَقُولُ فَالرَّجْلَ الَّذِي بُعِثَ فِيكُمْ. What do you say about the man was sent to you? Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. From Al-Amin, the trustworthy, to the one in the same in Al-Masjid Al-Haram. Uqba ibn Abi Mu'id came and placed the filth, the dirt of the camel on his back, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was in sujood. And a young girl, 6 years old, Fatima, Sayyidat Nisha'i Ahl al-Jannah, radiallahu anha, came to remove the filth from her father, Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to be called Sahirun aw Majnoon, magician or a crazy person, is the same person. Not anybody, not any common. He was the crown. He was the goal of Mecca and Quraysh and Arabs. Al-Amin. And for the sake of inviting people, calling people, and his sunnah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he had taken all this. We know when he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, went to At-Ta'if, what happened to him? Sheikh Yathrib spoke about people of Yathrib, known as Al-Madina later. He, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, lived in a way that all his life, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, night and day, was for his ummah. And in the day of Qiyamah, what he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, would say, all the anbiya, alayhim salatu wassalam, the best people Allah created, they will say, nafsi, nafsi, my nafs, my nafs, my nafs. But there is only one who would say, ya Rabbi ummati, ya Rabbi ummati, ya Rabbi ummati, our beloved Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. On his deathbed, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's leaving this world. And he left us the same month as he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was born, Rabi' al-Awwal. Rabi' al-Awwal. Fatima radiallahu anha, next to him, she said, wa karba abata. What anguish, what trouble, what difficult time my dear father is getting through. And he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, replied back to her, la karba ala abiki ba'da al-yawm. The anguish, the mental pain, the troubles that he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, had taken for us and for the sake of every one of us to be successful in this dunya and in the qabr in akhirah is gone. La karb ala abiki ba'da al-yawm. There is no karb upon your dear father after the day that he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, passed away and left our world. We love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we need to work on this love and look at ourselves, where we are from his blessed sunnah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and bring this sunnah in every action, every step we take in a practical way. Just before you rush out your house, you, the sister, taking your children to school, going shopping. You, the brothers, going where? Or taking the children on the way as well. Just a minute. Will you, and I represent Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is mahabbat, love for the humanities, for everyone. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا I'm sure everyone say here, إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ لِلْعَالَمِينَ You represent this. He said, Ya Allah, how many seconds will take? MashaAllah, my brother is waiting for me to be here, yes. How many seconds will take to say, Ya Allah, I am going to leave my house. Ya Allah, I'm going out. Ya Allah, please accept me to represent, to project the rahmat that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent with to everyone I see. Ya Allah, let them read what I have in my heart for them. Ya Allah, I love everyone I see, Muslim and non-Muslim. They are all the children of Adam. They are all the children of Nuh, the Nabi of Allah. They are all deserve your rahmat. Ya Allah, let me that alif al-wasl, that connection between their hearts and your heart, Ya Rabbal Alameen. How many seconds will it take? Take it. Take it. Da'wah ila Allah. Speak on behalf of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You don't know the whole Quran, you don't know the whole Qira'at, you don't know what tafsir, you don't know the jama, but you know one verse. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, بَلِّغُ عَنِّي وَلَوْ آيَةً. Convey on my behalf even a single verse. You learn it, or learn its meaning. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all of us. Who loves Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? We all. Who loves Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Say, we all love Rasulullah. Who is ready to convey the message on behalf of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? We all, yes, inshallah. Alhamdulillah, we all take the message to everyone. Take the message to everyone who is not here in this moment in time. Say, you are Muslim. You believe in Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You express your love to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the way you talk, in the way you walk, in the way you dress, in the way you get married, in the way you start business, in the way you drive, in the way you deal with your neighbors. May Allah Jalla Jalalu, through His rahmat and fadl, and this is a dua to Him, the Sami' Qareeb Mujib, the all listener, the all seer, all the time, Jalla Jalalu Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, to let us true lovers of our Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and grant us His mahabbat subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalalu at the end to bless all of us and bless everyone through His dua, her contribution, time-wise, or business-wise, thought-wise, to make this seerah conference possible with the rahmat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His fadl. I say on my behalf, on behalf of everyone, a big jazakumullah khairan. A big thank you for letting us come in together to remember and to remind ourselves. There is one, we love Him the most of all the makhluk of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we are not shy. We are not shy to show that we love Him and He's our role model. And we introduce His rahmat, His kindness, His mercy to everyone around us. We'll never be shy to tell everyone, please come, let me tell you something about my most beloved Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The one was sent to me as was sent to you, Mr. Smith, Mr. John, Sister Mary, Sister Tiffany. Let me speak to you about him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, my most beloved, my role model, that I live night and day to bring his sunnah into my life. Jazakumullah khairan, jazakumullah khairan. Thank you very much. Barakallahu feekum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillah ar-Rahman. Alhamdulillah. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه ملء السماوات وملء الارض وملء ما بينهما وملء ما شاء ربنا من شيء بعد اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على امامنا سيدنا نبينا حبيبنا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه وسلم اللهم يا أرحم الراحمين يا رب العالمين يا أكرم الأكرمين صلي وسلم وبارك على إمامنا وسيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم اللهم اجزه عنا خير ما جزيت به نبيا عن أمته ورسولا عن قومه اللهم امزه عنا خير ما جزيت به نبيا عن أمته ورسولا عن قومه اللهم وأحينا على سنته وتوفنا على ملته وأوردنا حوضه واسقنا من يده الشريفة شربة هنيئة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا هو الله يا أرحم الراحمين يا أكرم الأكرمين Oh Allah, send all salutation, all peace and blessings upon our Sayyid, our Master, our Imam, our Leader, our Habib, our most beloved, Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Oh Allah, reward him on behalf of his Ummah. Reward him on behalf of us. Reward him on behalf of our children and children. People to come to the last day, reward him. We cannot pay him back, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask you, we pray to you, ya Allah, to give him jaza al-khair,
sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The best you give jaza al khair to Nabi, to Rasul, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Allah, we cannot thank you for having our beloved Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in our lives. We cannot thank you to have his sunnah, his way of life, into our life. We cannot thank you enough, Ya Allah, to have him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as our role model. We love him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know, Ya Allah, but we are weak. We are weak. From time to time, we are shy. We are hesitant to show that we love him truly. Ya Allah, take this shyness and this weakness from our hearts. Ya Allah, Ya Rabbal Alameen, Ya Rahman Rahimeen. Let us live 24/7, night and day, in and out. Fill our hearts with true love for you, Ya Rabbal Alameen. We all believe you can, you are there, you hear us, you listen to us, you see us, you are Rabbul Alameen. We need the guidance you send to your Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As individuals, we are weak. As families, we are struggling. As community, many of us don't know their task, their mission. Why you send us? You send us khayra ummatin ukhrijat linnas. Ya Allah, you said it. Kuntum khayra ummatin ukhrijat linnas. We are the best nation being sent to the welfare, to the goodness of people. Ya Allah, please let us to implement this tournament night and day. Ya Allah, please, you are there. Accept us to bring our children, our grandchildren to Islam. Protect us from all evils, Ya Rabbal Alameen. It's you, Ya Allah, to take the whisper of shaitan, the tricks of shaitan, the new technology that's attacking our hearts, our homes, our families, and bring the blessed sunnah into our lives, into our 24/7, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Ya Allah, bless this gathering, Ya Rabbal Alameen, young and old, brothers and sisters. Ya Allah, let them all to take from here something to live with till they meet you. And Ya Allah, let me and everyone here and all the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to say it easily when our time of departure, when our time to go back to you, we say it firmly, sweetly, and nicely. La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Ya Allah, make it easy for me and for everyone when we are on our graves to answer Man Rabbuk, answer Allah. Man Rasuluk, who is your Rasul? It's Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because we live night and day his life. Ma Deenuk, what's your deen and Islam? Ya Allah, please, you the one guiding the first generation, Sahaba radiallahu anhu. Bring the tertib of Sahaba, the approach of Sahaba, the life of Sahaba, the people who are taking Islam as far as in China and Europe, East and West. And they share with everyone, Ya Allah, the beauty of Islam, the mercy of Islam, the greatness of Islam. Ya Allah, you send us here for many of us who are not originally or not based or not from this land, Ya Allah, let us be the means of all good, of peace and mercy for the locals and for the people who are around us. They are all our brothers and sisters in humanity. Ya Allah, please open their hearts to receive the right message that you send it to them through the fire of the seed of the Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam, our beloved Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Allah, let us to be good representatives, good ambassadors on behalf of our Habib, our Sayyid, our Imam, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rabbana atina fi dunya hasanatan وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم. وصل اللهم على إمامنا سيدنا نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أجمعين. والحمد لله رب العالمين. Jazakumullah khairan.